Hello, and welcome to this EE 228 quick lecture on signal classes. I wanted to make a video on a couple of the classes that I couldn't find great videos elsewhere. So those include the class of bounded signals, right-sided signals, left-sided signals, and then finally, causal signals. So as we discussed in class, signal, it can be thought of as just a function. And the functions that we're going to treat in this class are continuous time functions that go to the space of real numbers. So let's work out the definition of a bounded function, just in English first. It's a function is bounded if there is a upper and lower bound on the values that the function can take. So in math, that would be f that goes from the reals to the reals is bounded if there is an m, call it a real number m, such that f of t in, say, absolute value is less than or equal to m for all possible t. Okay, so what is this saying? Again, there is some max value m such that for any time you pick, the function at that time in magnitude is less than that max. This is basically analogous to finite duration, which put bounds on the left and right ends of the domain. A bounded signal has a top and a bottom, you can say. So an example, or a couple examples of this, are cosine. Cosine of t has a pretty easily max value of 1, plus minus 1. And another example of a bounded signal is, let's take 1 minus e to the minus t, and let's multiply that by a unit step. So we all know what cosine looks like. What does this function look like? Well, it's going to be 0 for all negative time, because the unit step is 0 for all negative time. So whatever this is, we're going to multiply by 0 and get 0. At 0, this is the unit step is going to be active now, so it's going to be take a value of 1. And at this t equals 0, this is 1 minus e to the 0, which is 1 minus 1, so that's 0. And as time goes on, this exponential decays. And so what we get is something that looks like this. That asymptotes at a value of 1. Okay. So this is a bounded signal that also has a max-min value of 1. Some anti-examples, or I can't think of a better word for this, but examples of signals that do not fall in this class are, say, f of t equals absolute value of t. Now this guy, of course, looks like the big V function. And you'll note that this is actually technically bounded below. So there is a min value, but there is no max value. And since we need them to have both to be bounded, I'm going to classify absolute value as unbounded. Another example of a signal that is not bounded is our old friend e to the t. Right? This starts low and goes off to infinity. Again, this is bounded below, but not bounded above. So these two are not bounded. A right-sided signal is a signal that is only active to the right of a certain value. So in math speak, that would be f, which maps from the reals to the reals, is, I'm going to abbreviate it, right-sided, if there is some a in the real number line such that f of t equals 0 for all t less than a. So again, there has to exist some point in the real number line that to the left of that point, the function is inactive, so to speak. The function only takes 0 values. So an example of a right-sided signal is a good old unit step. Unit step is 0 to the left of 0. So in this case, a would be 0. Another example is the rectangular pulse function. This is active below t equals negative 1/2. So these are both right-sided signals. One of which is finite duration, this one. The other one is infinite duration. So anti-examples include the time-reversed unit step. So this is, the unit step is always 1 when its argument is positive. The argument here is positive whenever t is negative. So this is the time-reversed unit step. And here you can never pick an a value such that the function is 0 before that value. Any negative time you pick, the function will always be 1 to the left of it, including if you pick a positive a. So if you were to say, let's say a equals 1, well, then it's not true that the function is not 0 for all time below a equals 1. And another anti-example is, say, cosine of t. And this guy is, of course, neither left nor right-sided, which brings me to left-sided. So if we know the definition for right-sided, the definition for left-sided follows pretty much directly. I'm going to say, you know, ditto marks for everything if there is a b in the real number line such that f of t equals 0 for all t greater than b. So this is, there has to be a right endpoint in order for the signal to be left-sided. Examples of left-sided signals include rect, again. Rect is both left and right-sided. And u of minus t. So this is our flipped around step function, and it is left-sided because it's inactive to the right of 0. And then anti-examples would be regular old u of t and, of course, cosine of t. Now, causal signals are a subset of right-sided signals. So all causal signals are right-sided, but the special bit for causal is A is the origin, or we're talking about they are 0 before the origin, t equals 0 point. So an example of this is our friend the unit step. The unit step is 0 to the left of the origin, so that makes it a causal signal. Another example is, say, e to the minus t times u of t. This is 0 for all negative time because we're multiplying an exponential times 0, and it is a decaying exponential in positive time. So you can see that we can actually make any signal causal if we multiply it by a unit step, and that's a kind of important feature. Okay, so an anti-causal signal, and this is the name of the class, anti-causal signals, are signals that would be causal if you flip time around. So an anti-causal is an example u minus t. So this is the exact opposite of what we need. This is active to the left of 0 only. And then, of course, there are non-causal signals as well. Non-causal, an example of a non-causal signal would be that rect pulse. This is active both before the time equals 0 and after the time equals 0. So even though it's right-sided, it's not causal because it has this bit before t equals 0. All right, thanks everyone.